I am Pierre-Emmanuel Rautou. I'm working in Paris at the Paris Research Center on Inflammation. I'm very happy to present you our data recently published in the Journal of Clinical Investigations on arterial events occurring in patients with myeloproliferative neoplasms. Myeloproliferative neoplasms are clonal hematologic disorders characterized by proliferation of myeloid precursors. Most of these diseases are due to a mutation called JAK2V617F mutation. The first cause of death in patients with myeloproliferative neoplasm is due to arterial events, including stroke and myocardial infarction. Intriguingly, these events occur in the absence of atherosclerotic plaque, so that the mechanism underlying these events remains elusive. It was thus our goal to understand these arterial events, and Dr. Johanne Poisson and Mrs. Marion Tanguy, who did most of the experiments in this article, will present you our data.
The first major finding of our study is the demonstration that JAK2V617F myeloproliferative neoplasm, that we will refer for the rest of our talk as JAK2-mutated myeloproliferative neoplasm, induces a considerable increase in arterial contraction.
To study vascular reactivity, we used two kinds of experiments, one ex vivo with aorta using a myography, which allow us to record aortic contraction exposed to vasoactive drug during the experiment. Secondly, in vivo, we recorded femoral artery superfused with vasoactive drug, which allow us to measure femoral contraction. First of all, we used a mouse model carrying JAK2 mutation, which developed a myeloproliferative neoplasm. As you can see, mice carrying JAK2 mutation displayed a major increase in arterial contraction, here in red, in comparison of wild-type artery in blue, both ex vivo and in vivo. Because of the high rate of myocardial infarction without significant coronary stenosis reported in patients with myeloproliferative neoplasm, we investigated cardiac vascular bed by performing electrocardiography in JAK2 mutated mice and their littermate control. After intravenous injection of phenylephrine, JAK2 mutated mice displayed electrocardiogram modifications, including bradycardia and arrhythmia, that are indirect signs of coronary spasm.
The second major finding of our work is the contribution of JAK2 mutated erythrocyte derived microvesicles to this increased arterial contraction associated with myeloproliferative neoplasms.
Microvesicles are cell-derived membranous structures shed from the plasma membrane and released in the extracellular compartment. They are known to be involved in intercellular communication and in the pathophysiology of cardiovascular events. As you can see on left panel, wild-type aorta exposed to JAK2 mutated erythrocyte-derived microvesicles in red display this major increased contraction in response to vasoactive drug in comparison of wild-type aorta exposed to wild-type erythrocyte-derived microvesicles in blue. The same results were found using microvesicles from patients carrying JAK2 mutation in red in comparison of healthy control in blue in the right panel.
We also demonstrated that NO pathway inhibition and endothelial oxidative stress are implicated in this increased arterial contraction in myoproliferative neoplasm.
Indeed, aorta from JAK2 mutated mice in red display an impaired vasodilatation in response to acetylcholine, both ex vivo on the left panel and in vivo in the right panel. In addition, as you can see on the right panel, reactive oxygen species production was 4 times higher in the aortic endothelium from JAK2 mutated mice than controls.
To understand the underlying mechanisms, we performed proteomic analysis on microvesicles from JAK2 mutated and controlled erythrocytes.
We look at proteins involved in oxidative stress and discover that myeloperoxidase expression, which is a strong pro-oxidant protein, was much higher in microvesicles derived from JAK2 mutated than in control erythrocytes. We confirmed it by Western blot. To ascertain the role of myeloperoxidase, we perform a direct and irreversible inhibition of myeloperoxidase on the microvesicles derived from JAK2 mutated erythrocytes in orange on the left panel, which reversed completely the increased endothelial oxidative stress.
In addition to demonstrating how JAK2 mutation induces this increased arterial contraction, our results open new potential therapeutic perspectives to prevent cardiovascular events in patients with myeloproliferative neoplasms.
Indeed, we demonstrated that simvastatin, a well-known and easily accessible drug, strongly improved arterial response to vasoconstrictive agent in our myeloproliferative mouse model. These results thus paved the way for testing simvastatin to prevent arterial events in patients with myeloproliferative neoplasms.
In conclusion, our results demonstrate that microvesicles derived from JAK2 V617F erythrocytes are responsible for a very strong arterial contraction that could explain the arterial events observed in patients with myeloproliferative neoplasms. These microvesicles derived from JAK2 V617F erythrocytes carry myeloperoxidase, are taken up by endothelial cells where they increase oxidative stress, thereby inhibiting nitric oxide pathway and explaining this increased arterial contraction. Importantly, our results also suggest that simvastatin, by improving nitric oxide pathway, could be an attractive drug to prevent arterial events in patients with myeloproliferative neoplasm. I thank you for your attention.